now for many, many years. As you know, our connection to Mankind Welfare Trust is through our Hazur Qibla Peer Sahib Qibla, Hazrat Peer Muhammad Naqib Rahman Sahib Sajjad Nashin Zabari Adjad Gashmi, who gave us their permission in 2004 to formally set up an organization. And alhamdulillah, when there are many other organizations in the world that are named by the people who set those organizations up, or they are associated with their family or their work, or in a very limited state. But when Hazur Qibla Alam were thinking about what this organization was called, they actually read out the ayah of the Quran Kareem, that when Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam chose to come to this world, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent them as a blessing for the whole of creation. So as a basis of that ayah, our Qibla Peer Sahib named the organization Mankind Welfare Trust, because we are not here for the purpose of one person. We are not here for the purpose of one household. We are not here for the purpose of one country or indeed one religion. We are here for the benefit of everybody. So in 2004, we set a board of trustees, which were essentially followers of Hazur Qibla Peer Sahib and associated with the Dabai Ali Gashmi. And these trustees are dotted around all over the UK because we wanted to represent everybody from the UK. And in 2005, and many of you know, we have an affiliation to the number 12, and particularly because that's the day that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam chose to bless the earth with their worldly presence. So if you're associated, naturally, we didn't plan to be registered on the 12th of July, but the letter that we got from the Charity Commission was dated the 12th of July 2005. And July is the 7th month, if you add the 5 and the 2 together, you also get 12, but never mind. We also, since then, from a small beginning, we last year, alhamdulillah, with the kindness and generosity of many of our brothers and sisters in Tariqah, but also people outside of Tariqah, indeed people outside of the fold of Islam, have helped us to deliver a number of projects. And 2011 was a wonderful year for us. We were able to raise just over £500,000. Alhamdulillah, in the space of, you know, 6 or 7 years, that's a tremendous achievement, but it's in no way, it is very small in comparison with the goals and the aims which we've set ourselves. I would request this staff at the back of the stage to please maintain a bit of silence if possible, thank you. 2012 is a most blessed year because of its association with the number 12. And in 2012, in the city of Medina Sharif, Hazur Qibla Peer Sahib announced that Hazur Qibla Sahibzada Wala Shan, Qibla Peer Muhammad Hassan Hasibur Rahman Sahib, who's the physical and spiritual son of Hazur Qibla Alam, they have chosen to be the patron of Mankind Welfare Trust. So we have Hazur Qibla Alam as the founding father, and Hazur Qibla Sahibzada Wala Shan, who are our patron. We are immensely grateful and immensely blessed to have these two personalities who under whose fold I can see nothing but success. As I said, 2012 is a blessed year, and this is our first, despite the fact that alhamdulillah we've been able to raise £500,000, we've never held a public charity event before. So again, 2012 is a new beginning for us. This is our first, and alhamdulillah, inshallah Rahman, first of many, many events which we hope to hold in the future. So what do? We are associated with of course, Idgah Sharif. Idgah Sharif is Idgah Sharif. We are an organization that is under the umbrella of Idgah Sharif. In addition to all of the work that is done in Idgah Sharif, these are some of the things that we as an organization, in the form of Mankind Welfare Trust, are doing at the moment. We have set up education establishments primarily in our home country of Pakistan, in the city of Rawalpindi, both for girls and for boys, and more of that later. We have embarked on a number of healthcare projects, some of which we'll mention today, but as you know, our home country Pakistan was devastated by the floods more recently and then the earthquake some time back. And as a result of the diseases, the illnesses that spread, we have started a healthcare program. Particularly, In the province of Sindh in Pakistan, we have started a water purification and provision program for all the brothers and sisters who have been affected by the floods. One thing which is not very well publicized, and purely because you know, we are instructed to give with our right hand without the knowledge of our left hand. However, we do sponsor a lot of weddings for people who are poor, who cannot afford to get married. So we give them money, we hold the ceremonies for them, and help them to get started on a new life together. We also include economic empowerment, which helps people to help themselves to projects on their own land, on their own, within their own family. More recently, particularly in the UK, we've started to do a lot of community cohesion work, so we do a lot of interfaith work, inter-community work, and many of you will know that during this tour of Hazrat Qibla Pir Sahib and Hazrat Qibla Sahib Zada Wala Shan to the UK and Europe, we held an audience with, I'm not going to get them to be quiet, so I'm just going to carry on. We held an audience with the Archbishop of Canterbury at Lambeth Palace, which was wonderful for the Archbishop, but it was also wonderful for us to be regarded as guests of honour on an official state visit in honour of Qibla Pir Sahib. On the same day, we held an event, an interfaith event at the House of Lords, which was kindly sponsored by Lord Sheikh. And that culminated in a lot of hard work with brothers and sisters in this room. And alhamdulillah, inshallah Rahman, will continue to do that work going forward. As I mentioned before, I keep referring back to Pakistan because you know, most of the people I see in this room are from our wonderful country of Pakistan. We have helped on a number of occasions for disaster relief back home, as I mentioned during the earthquake and the flood. And of course, many of you who are associated with the Bayan Dead Rashid know that many of us sponsor food programs. We sponsor Qurbani, collective Qurbanis, under the stewardship of our Holy House. And of course, it's time that we mention this now, that the month of Ramadan, as it approaches us, alhamdulillah, in a few days' time, that we will be holding Ramadan Iftars again in the city of Rawalpindi, Pakistan. Last but not least, we have a lot of projects that are sponsored through Zakat, Sadaqah, and of course, Eid. It's appropriate to mention, we have a few scholars in the room today. There's a few questions asked today about, it's the month of Ramadan and we want to give our zakat, we want to give our money towards, as a result of that holy month. I am assured by scholars in this room and outside that all the money that you give today as zakat, we are able to legitimately, under Islamic law, to spend it on the projects that we will talk to you about later on. So if you were thinking about spending your zakat on projects, we have two projects here that should fit the bill. So please pay heed to what we're about to say later on. Now, the real purpose of today, so that's a little bit of background of who we are and what we do. The real purpose of today is that we want to raise money for two projects. In addition to those specific projects, our current work that we do. Obviously, as you know, as many of you know, we've just completed a tour of the UK and Europe, and that's part of our Inspiring Individuals program. And the essence of that program is through the shuyukh of the Bayan Dead Rashid to sit in Mahafil and listen to the stories and the life of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and try to increase our closeness and our love for Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The sole purpose of the visit of the Shuyukh of Ibrahim is nothing else but to draw their families, their friends and their followers closer to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We of course mentioned food provision during hunger. We mentioned this before, but the Shabir is, I think, is in the audience here. Some while back we calculated or we estimated the number of people that we provide food provisions for throughout the year. And we believe that, give or take, maybe a few hundred thousand, we believe that we provide well over 3 million meals a year in the city of Rawalpindi. Mentioned to you the health program. We are today going to ask you to make some pledges and buy raffle tickets for these wonderful prizes too, because we intend to build a clinic in Rawalpindi, Pakistan. We are also in association, and I mentioned this before, with the Crystal Plaza Foundation from Birmingham, with Malika Sorsal. We are supporting the construction of a hospital in the part called Kurdistan in Pakistan. And we, of course, are asking you to dig deep today for a further project, which is in Gujarat, India. The project already exists, but we are wanting to work with another charitable trust to support the expansion of that project. We just wanted to show you some of the work that we do. I just mentioned to you the project in Kandasena being built on, through the support of Chris Plaza Foundation and, of course, Mankind Welfare Trust. This work, as you can see, the various stages of construction, it is our aim to have this project ready for inshallah Rahman the first quarter of 2013. So it's already started, I think construction is well underway. Buildings, we put a perimeter wall, we dug deep for water and electricity substation, and the work is continuing there. That inshallah Rahman is what that hospital will look like in a few months' time inshallah. Mentioned to you some of the work that we do, and we just wanted to show you some pictures just highlight some of the work that we've been doing in the last year or so. On the top, my right, you will see at a function with the British ambassador in Pakistan. Many people in this audience are in that photograph today. And that's part of our building good relationships with people of the world, to tell them the true face of Islam and to show them the true face of Pakistan and Muslim. They also have, I mentioned before, a meeting of Muslim Pakistan with the Archbishop of Canterbury in the Palace, everyone. We also talked about some of the work that we've done in Pakistan for victims of the floods. These are some of the lorries that we took with the permission of Zulfiqar Bhutto to all provinces throughout Pakistan. We mentioned some of the work that we did. I think the earthquake is a very old photograph. That's the work that we did with Al Mustafa Trust in Pakistan for the victims of the earthquake. And here's what we mentioned, some of the programs, the food and hunger programs that we sponsor in Pakistan as well. Some of the more recent activities, this photograph is from the event that we held at the House of Lords. This is an event at Manfred Minar Park that we held in Birmingham. Some photographs, and I think that's the latest photograph of the most beautiful Manfred that I've ever been to yesterday in the Islamic Sanctuary of Oakland. I think many of you were there. I'm still in the zone of enjoying the aftermath of that event. So now, that's a little bit about who we are, about what we do, and about what we want to achieve. Where we've got to today is being possible through, first of all, the special and the sincere prayers that all you people and all of your families present in the court of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in the court of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, for our success. Coupled with that, our success hinges upon the generosity and the kindness of all those people in this room and further afield. And we want you to help us achieve our goals further still. I'm going to go quiet because I'm going to be coming a little bit hoarse now. I want to introduce to you one of the best people that I've had the pleasure of knowing. And I don't say that lightly, I don't say that just because he's here. He is genuinely a great, great person. And I think it is for that, his generosity, his kindness, his patience, his ability to take many, many people with him of different backgrounds and of different understandings together, that he was chosen by our Muhammad Abu Sahib as President of Mankind Welfare Trust to lead this organization to future success. And just before he comes along on stage, I'd like to, it's traditional for people to clap, but I think, as I said, that this event is slightly different to other events. I think we will introduce Qibla Barrister Rasim Ghaffar Sahib in the traditional Qibla's way. So as he comes on stage, I'm going to say a nara, and I'd like you to respond to that nara. Nara takbir! Allah! I know you're all hungry, we'll feed you afterwards. I want you to say that with a bit more strength. Narai Takbir!
Allah!
Narai Risalat!
Ya